Hello everyone, this is Travis with Siler Instrument here. We put together a quick little video to show you how you would set up the Phantom4 RTK with an Ntrip server. So that'd be some of the different state networks out there. In this case, we're using a privately run network. So it's pretty straightforward once you know what you're looking for. So what we'll do first is bring up our Ntrip caster in a browsing window. So usually you have to use Internet Explorer for this. In this case, we're looking at the VRS now. So the URL is vrsnow.us. Then we put a colon in there followed by 2101, which is the port number for that caster. So we take a look here. We get a bunch of information. It's not formatted very well. It's hard to decipher the information that you're actually looking for. So instead, we'll use a piece of software called the BKG Ntrip Client, or BNC. And here's the location where it comes from. It's from a German government geodesy group here, and they put this out for public use. So there's the link that we need for the Windows installer. I've already got this installed. Once you run it, this is what you get here. So we're going to add a stream, click it down in the bottom left, and we're going to say caster. And then we're going to enter that caster host that we typed in earlier. Again, it's vrsnow.us. The caster port is a standard 2101. And then we're going to click the Get Table button there. So that comes out, and now we have a lot more information that we can decipher what we're looking for. So the mount point, that's the most important thing that we need for the Phantom4 RTK that we're getting from this program. So what we want is RTCM 3.1 or RTCM 3.2. Both are compatible now with the latest version of firmware for the Phantom4 RTK. So we're looking for that. We've also got a couple different options. You'll see there's three of them. At the time this video was recorded, only 3.1 was compatible. So that's the one I'll grab here. But you see for 3.1, there are two different options. There's GPS and then GPS plus GLONASS. There's actually more than just GLONASS in that. There's also Galileo and Beidou and all the different options there. So what I want is that mount point. I want to make sure I'm not using the GPS because that would limit the number of satellites we could get. So I want the GNSS version that's selected there. So I'm going to make note of that, write it down, do whatever you have to do. And then what we're going to want to do is switch over to the Phantom4 RTK controller next. So we hop over here, and what we're doing here is I've just got the screen projected from the remote controller onto my laptop, and that's where we're making the recording. Click on the fly button, and then we're going to see it's actually sitting on top of my truck on the topper on the back, and because of that we're going to get some compass errors here for sure. Now you'll see it's already fixed, so it is already in there, but I'll show you the settings I've got in the RTK settings here. So Ntrip host, again, vrsnow.us, port is 2101, there's my username, my password is masked there, and there's the mount point. I accidentally added a character there, we'll get rid of that. And when I've got that set in correctly, I'm just going to confirm here. Yes, that's actually it. I'm going to say done. And you can see everything set up in there. We're actually already fixed. And you can see the number of satellites and all the different metrics there. So if you notice, latitude, longitude, and altitude is not changing on the base, and it shouldn't, unless you're moving a significant difference from where you started with a virtual reference station, that is. So I think it depends on the setting of the individual server, but some, I believe it's after 6 or maybe 10 miles, they'll change the virtual location to reduce the modeled error that comes out of the solution. So in this case, you see where that's at. If you were nearby a physical station, it would probably mount to that. Then below we can see the number of satellites, that sort of thing. And then I believe it's a standard deviation of your estimated error there is the bottom. So that's it. If you've got any questions, throw them in the comments below, or reach out to us by email at emergingtech@silerinst.com. Thanks.